To set up or configure your system, please go to the setup icon here. And then a setup window will open. Under communications, you will find your devices here on the left side. The major pumps means your buffer or LUN pump, and the minor pump your feed or sample pump. Please don't choose your EV detector here as it is part of the installation. Here you see the right port numbers according to the chosen LAN and COM ports which were entered in the Purity Chrome ini file. On the right side you can choose the correct drivers for your devices. As the software here runs as demo version, I can see the correct drivers because no devices are connected. Therefore I will show you a screenshot. Here you can use for example the drivers for your different Knauer pumps. Lower part of the communication window you can enter the number of your connected valves. The first valve is an injection valve and it has two positions, load and inject. So you enter here too. Under port you enter the LAN or COM port which you have entered for this valve in the Purity Chrome ini file. The type you can choose here, and it is a Knauer injection valve. If you have a multi-position valve, you would use Knauer multi-position valve. And for example, if you have a Vici valve, then you would enter here Vici valve. The second valve is the valve of the fraction collector. You have to enter the valve of the fraction collector here too, because the software discriminates between the collector and the valve what is normally in the arm of the fraction collector. The type is a standard valve. It has two positions, waste and fractions, and the port number is driver 5.
Under control inputs, you can program a special action depending on a signal from a trigger cable using a manual injection valve or from a gain port adapter using the air sensor. For a signal from a trigger cable, you have to choose event box input 1. And for a signal from the gain port adapter, you have to choose gain port input 1. 2 or 3 or 4. And you have here the possibility to stop all, depending on the signal, to start a run, or to put a run on hold. Under presets, you can set the presets for your major pump system or the minor pump system. For example, you can set here maximum pressure and a minimum pressure or the default flow rate. I would recommend to enter here a 0 for the default flow rate, because after saving the setup, the pumps will start with the entered flow rate here. Here you can choose the start and end position of your collector. If the collector should start in home position, you have to enter 0 here. The limiter is a special feature of the software which calculates the pump volume. Under limiter activation, you could choose when the calculation should start. In case we have a fraction collector, you would enter here the valve of the fraction collector, and it should start if the valve changes the position from waste to fraction. So we enter here not waste. After a special volume, which you can enter here, or a special time, the collector should perform a step to the next vial. So we put here, enter here, control collector next while. If you fractionate with a fraction valve, you would enter the fraction valve here and here in controlled valves. I wouldn't recommend to use a time limit, because if you program your method based on volume or column volume, it would be very difficult to calculate this volume. In annotation, you decide which text should appear. If fractionation starts, here would appear the text fraction. If the fractionation stops, here there would appear the text waste. Or if the collector performs a step, then here would appear step to position, for example, 3. In the lower part of the window, you choose when the annotation should appear. So the waste annotation should appear if our fraction collector valves is on waste. The fraction text should appear if our fraction collector valve is on not waste. And the step text should appear if the controlled collector performs a step. Under dead time or volume, you have to enter the delay volume. The delay volume is the volume between your fraction collector and your UV detector. Just to keep in mind, if you use a fraction collector for fractionation, you have to enter the volume under controlled collector and for the fraction valve as well. I would not recommend to use time, because if you create your method based on volume or column volume, it would be too complicated to calculate the exact delay volume. Here you can define a user-defined channel. For example, if you have two pressure monitors before the column and after the column, then you can enter here the two pressure channels and subtract them from each other, and then a software would show you the pressure what is over the column as user-defined channel.
In descriptions, you can give your valves user-defined names. First valve, we've named injection valve with the position load and inject, and the second valve, Foxy valve, with the position waste and fraction. In program colors, you can change every color as you like. Simply double click on it and change it. If you want to save your setup, you can do it in File and Save Configuration. If you want to load another configuration, you can go here, click Load Configuration and search for your wanted configuration. Closing the setup, you will be asked if you want to save the configuration.